Did you know that you could actually make YouTube videos without actually owning a camera? You don't have to film yourself to make videos. You can actually make what is called faceless videos, which is videos that you create using other video assets while actually using your own audio. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to do that start to finish as you watch this actual faceless video as I show you how to do it. So let's get into it.
You gotta just press record.
Now, the first thing you're gonna wanna do is create your script. Now, you can go two ways around this. You can create a word for word verbatim script based off of what you're gonna say in your video, or you can create a detailed outline. Either way, you're gonna wanna create a script that will allow you to create a comprehensive and fluid audio recording that would complete an actual video. One tip that may save you some time in editing is actually writing some of the B-roll shots that coincide with your script so that you can refer to that when you're editing your video. And if you don't know what B-roll is, it's simply what is going on top of your audio when you're creating a faceless video. After you have completed writing out your script, it is now time to record your audio. Now, I do think it's important, although you don't have a camera, I would encourage you to capture the best quality sound of audio as possible. And so if you're using your smartphone's onboard mic to capture your audio, just make sure you're doing it in a carpeted and fabricated room or a room with a lot of furniture so that there's no echo, or invest in a cheap mic like the Samson Q2U or a Deity D4 Duo. Both of these mics will give you incredible audio, and you could either plug it right into your computer or plug it into your smartphone to capture your audio. Now, in this example, I will actually be using the sponsor of this video, Camtasia, which is an incredible software to create videos with. You just wanna make sure that whatever audio recording software you're using, that you just select your audio source correctly so that you capture through the mic that you wanna use. Once you have recorded your audio, I would encourage you to edit it down and cut out any of the fluff and maybe add any music that you have wanted. Essentially, create the full audio experience of your video so that all you have to do now is then plug in your video, which is the next tip, is to actually get your video assets for your audio recording. Now, there's a handful of ways that you can actually get footage, but one reason why I like Camtasia is because they actually have an assets library with over 20 million assets. Whether it's videos, sound effects, or motion backgrounds, you can browse their library for whatever it is you need. You could just simply put podcast in their search box and then find a clip, click the Camtasia link, and then it'll actually just populate inside of your Camtasia software, which is super convenient. Another way is by capturing your screen, and this is best if you're showcasing how to do something on a software or program, and you're just showcasing something, and having the audio underneath that video is gonna be super helpful as a tutorial or what have you. And Camtasia has a screen recorder built in. I would say this is one of my favorite features about Camtasia, is the ability to easily screen record. So if you don't look good on a certain day, or you don't wanna be on camera, or you don't wanna record on camera at all, you can just use Camtasia to conduct your screen records, which is really nice because it just shoots right into the program, and that's super easy for beginners. Now, the other way that you can actually get B-roll is to actually shoot it yourself. So maybe you don't want to be on camera looking down at a lens, but if you want to film yourself do something, but use audio voiceover to talk about what it is you're demonstrating, this is super easy, and you can literally use your smartphone to capture your own B-roll, and it honestly makes it very interesting if you're able to do that. I absolutely love creators that do this. One to include is Matthew Encina. He does a lot of desk tours and productivity tips and things like that, but all his videos are voiceover, and then he just gets strategic B-roll to fill in on his audio recording. Now that you have your video assets in your project, you can now add them to your recording and start to build out your video. I think if you wrote down your shot list inside of your script, this is when it would come handy as you start to add them on top of your recorded audio. And feel free to cut and maneuver whatever it is you need to do based off of what video editing software you're using. But I like how on Camtasia, just simple slices or drags will allow me to trim the ends of any video that I need to. And then once you've taken the time to add all the footage onto your project, it is now time to render and export your video and get it up for uploading. Special thanks to Camtasia for sponsoring this video. And if you actually want to check out Camtasia and try it yourself, be sure to check out the link down in the description below. If you consider yourself a beginner creator, then this is a great software to get started and even grow with, as they have so many different ways that you can use it to help you further your career as a content creator. Now, if you want to deep dive more into how to create a YouTube script, be sure to click or tap the screen, because Nolan really breaks it down and makes it easy on how to do so. Or you can check out another video from Think Media by clicking or tapping the screen. And I can't wait to see you in a future video. Peace.